O'Brien grew up in Los Angeles?
That's right.
Really?
Uh-huh.
I can't believe.
Well, I was born in our home. My mom was afraid she'd get our kids mixed up with a hospital.
Uh-huh.
So we were born at home, two blocks from Chavez Ravine. That's where our home was,
uh-huh.
which is now the Dodger Stadium.
Your father was a police captain?
He was captain of LAPD.
LAPD?
Yes.
Like, what's his name right now? The guy who's at...
back in the 20s, 30s,
uh-huh.
he was the, you know, chief was the head of the whole
right.
shebang.
There was not that much crime then, was there really?
Oh, well, not riots and thing. I tell you, my dad wouldn't have stood for what went on. I don't know how they handled this, but I don't think it was
but you know,
were
Brian,
on their toes.
Tell me, first on stage, you got scared. Something happened. You were in a show called...
Meet the People.
Meet the People.
We opened...
In Hollywood here?
Yep. We opened at the Assistance League Playhouse. It was a darling little theater.
Uh-huh.
And the show became such a hit that we moved to the Hollywood Playhouse on Vine Street.
Right.
But Mr. L.B. Mayer saw me in the show, and actually 2 weeks after we opened, I'd made a test, and I was signed... At MGM?
MGM signed you right away, just like that.
Uh-huh.
In 2 weeks in the show. What happened? You got scared on stage? That stiffness of your routine?
Yeah.
You were singing a song and you didn't even know what you were doing? What?
Well, I thought I knew what I was doing. I was doing an Ethel Merman, I thought, because I loved Ethel's
right,
style.
Right.
But when I got in front of an audience, and instead of, you know, doing all the gestures that my dear friend did, this is all I could do.
Oh,
that was far as I could raise my hands.
You didn't even move your neck.
No, well, just barely. This was all the rhythm. And this and the face, nothing happened.
Blank.
Singing up a storm.
Uh-huh. The audience...
They laughed.
Did they?
They thought I was
Is that where
a comedian.
Louis B. Mayer got his idea to
he
sign
He must
you?
Have. He must have.
Signed you with MGM right away?
Yeah.
First picture.
And
film.
It's called Hullabaloo. I can't say that. That's the first one I sang in, but they put me in a movie called Sky Murder with Walter Pigeon.
Right.
So they gave me a part where, you know, all the gals were scared, so I screamed a lot.
Right.
And then we used I saw Jimmy Stewart yesterday out at the Motion Picture Home, and been seeing Philadelphia Story.
Right.
They've been showing it, and the same house they used in Philadelphia Story we used in Sky Murder on the back lot of
uh-huh.
MGM.
Uh-huh.
But the first movie that I sang in was called Hullabaloo. It was the a takeoff on what Orson Welles did on radio.
On radio. Well, who was in that film with you?
Frank Morgan.
Frank Morgan, great guy.
Dan Daly.
Dan
Virginia
Daly.
Gray. I can't think that far
God,
back.
God, that's you know, Sam. That sounds all like 20th Century Fox people. Dan Daly, Virginia Gray.
Yeah, he came over to MGM. Uh huh.
But MGM was the studio.
Oh yes.
At that time, second film. What was the second film, Virginia? Do you remember?
The Big Store.
The Big Store.
With Groucho.
Groucho.
You know, the Marx brothers.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
Were they fun to work with?
Oh,
Groucho Marx.
Crazy.
Were they?
Oh yeah.
Did you sing in this film?
Rockabye Baby,
uh-huh.
and everybody loves that song.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and I became really close friends with Groucho and his daughter Miriam.
Uh-huh.
I'm invited to their home all the time, and
uh-huh.
and then Groucho was going to do a radio show, Pabst Blue Ribbon Beer.
Right.
So he wanted me on the show, so MGM let me do that. I was uh-huh. filming when they'd have a limo take me to the. To CBS mm-hmm. to tape the radio show, which I did for 13 weeks.
You did radio.
Uh-huh.
Was it fun doing radio?
I did a lot of radio.
Was it fun, Virginia?
Yes.
Tell me about being on MGM contract for so many years.
Uh-huh.
I mean, with Judy Garland. How many films did you do with Judy Garland?
Well, the Harvey Girls was the...
First.
Well, that was yes, and that was... we were in a lot of movies,
that's
you know,
what I mean.
Together.
Really, but did a lot of films with Judy.
Well,
really?
Just... Uh-huh.
Judy was a very close friend of yours.
Oh, she was a doll. I loved her.
You
loved
her in,
working with her.
You met her with the Harvey Girls? Is that the first time you met Judy? When you did the film Harvey Girls?
I can't
on
remember.
The set? That's a great story.
I think so.
Great story.
I think so.
That was a great film. Did you have fun doing it?
Oh, I loved doing it.
Really?
Because I was
Margaret O'Brien was in that too, wasn't she? Little Margaret? No, wasn't?
Uh-uh.
Okay, okay. Who was in Virginia something? There's another Virginia in that too. Wasn't there another Virginia?
In the Harvey Girls?
The Harvey Girls?
No, Sid Charisse.
Sid Charisse, go ahead.
Uh-huh.
Who else?
Marjorie Maine.
Right.
And that, the main.
There was another girl. There was another girl there, I thought. You don't remember?
Don't remember.
Okay, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
Well, I know it doesn't.
It was a great
because
film.
Because I can't.
A great, great film.
Yeah.
What song did you do in the Harvey Girls? What was that?
Johnny Mercer and Harry Warren wrote. I was hoping to be roping something wild in the wild, wild west.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, that was fun.
Yeah, and then, of course, the songs that I did with Judy and Sid, It's a Cold, Cold World.
Uh-huh. And that's the song I'm thinking of. It's a cold, cold,
cold
world.
World.
When your three girls were up the, by the window.
On the balcony.
On the balcony. That's the one I was thinking of. But I thought Margaret O'Brien was in that. I don't know why.
I saw Margaret yesterday.
Did you?
My little friend, yeah.
How is she doing?
Oh, just fine.
You guys, you still meet your old pals around when you're going out?
Uh-huh.
You're still friendly
goodness,
and all?
Yes.
How do you
and
guys?
And Virginia was there yesterday, Virginia Mayo.
Virginia Mayo.
From her little old trip.
And Sid Charisse, you see a lot, do you?
Well, I have a picture over here that, no, she's on Broadway now doing Grand Hotel.
She just got back from Broadway.
Oh, is she
just
back already?
Yes, she is. Boy, look at this. I want to show this. This is Till the Clouds Roll By with Judy Garland. And look at you in the back of the cover of this. Look, that is you there. Oh, look how beautiful. Oh. What song was that we were singing in that? Do you remember?
Life upon the wicked stage ain't ever what a girl supposes. Life on the
great.
Stage.
That's a great, great. That's Jerron Kern.
Yes.
God.
That's a life story. That
this is the whole life story of it, yes.
Yes.
Judy Garland, I want to get back. Did she take pills at the time you knew her at the beginning of her career? Or was it hard for her? Do you remember anything on the sets at the time?
She wasn't showing up at work.
Well, she wasn't.
No. And then we'd sit on the train. She said, oh, I was up all night, Virginia. She said, just felt like my teeth were crumbling away or something. You know, I didn't know what was going on. And I said, Judy, you're not showing up. And I was expecting my first daughter. Uh-huh. And I was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And I was doing scenes with pillows on my lap and behind.
So you were
whatever.
Pregnant when you were doing the film?
Yes, with Terry.
With Terry, your first,
yes.
Is it your first girl?
Uh-huh.
How many do you have?
I have three daughters
three
and
daughters.
A son.
That's fun. You were
yeah,
you're
pregnant.
A picture.
Of my son and my three daughters and three of my grandchildren.
Oh, great. I love to see
this.
Here, show this. Can we get a real close-up on that? Voila. Oh, this is the O'Brien family. Oh, nice.
Yeah, and three of my grandchildren live in Boise, Idaho.
Uh-huh.
So this is the other three that live here.
Do you celebrate the Irish Day, St. Patrick's Day, O'Brien, Virginia?
Oh, well, this St. Patrick's Day, guess where we were?
Where were you?
We were out at Martha Ray's. She invited us out. Mark Harris.
You
yeah.
got Mark Harris's picture
he
here. Is that her husband?
Yes.
That's her new husband?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
He's a doll. I love
is
him.
Is he? Is he fun?
Yeah. He
His
pulled
name
me
is
up.
Mark.
He said, Virginia, we're going to sing. So we got up and sang.
How's Mark, Martha Ray doing nowadays?
Well,
I hear she's getting better, is she?
Yeah, a little.
Is she?
But she's in a wheelchair, you know.
Is she?
Uh-huh.
She's such life fun.
Oh, I know.
That's
we were invited to her home, you know, for dinner on St. Patty's Day.
Uh-huh.
You know, of course, I saw you on Saturday out at Century
the St. Patrick's,
City.
Yeah, in Century City, we did the St. Patrick's show.
Yeah.
Tell me about living, you're not living in Los Angeles, you're living where?
In Wrightwood.
Wrightwood, and you
yes.
are the mayor of Wrightwood.
And it is
a mayor.
The yeah.
Come on, how do you feel being a mayor, Virginia O'Brien?
Oh, come see, come saw.
How many of the city?
No, it's fun.
Is it fun?
Yeah.
Is it cold up there?
Well, it is. You know, we got our snow, and we had a lot of snow this year. In fact, we still have a little bit in the mountains.
I think it's great up there in the mountains.
The Mountain High Ski Resort.
What does a mayor like you, what is your duties?
Well, we put on shows in the summertime, like a chili cook-off.
Right.
And then we have a mountaineer day with and we have band, you know, bands coming in and out and little booths where, you know, people come up and sell their wares
and
you know, we just keep little things like that going.
You
close
good,
down the main
so
street.
You're
we only
good,
have one street.
You only have one street?
One main street.
Any Howard Johnson's area? One flavor probably, right?
Yeah.
Tell me about MGM days, Virginia. Oh, going back, thinking back. Fond memories?
Oh, goodness, yes.
No regrets at all in those days?
Oh, my goodness, no.
None? You've had a good time there on the set?
I loved it. It was fun going to work, you know.
Uh-huh. What do you mean by fun going to work?
Well, work, because I love to sing.
When it's work.
And then I worked with so many, you know, with Lucille and Lucille Ball and Red Skelton. Of course,
the girl I was thinking of is Lucille Brenner. Remember
Bremer.
Her?
Yeah,
that's
of course. That's
it. Lucille that's Bremer. The girl I was thinking of. She was beautiful. Whatever happened to her?
She moved to Mexico or South America. She doesn't come in town too often.
She doesn't. They stay away. They just.
Uh-huh.
But Virginia Bryan still comes to Hollywood.
Well.
You go to all the openings. You go. You keep yourself busy.
Oh, yes.
Look at this. You were just in London. They did a whole thing of Stairway to the Stars. Look at this. Let's look at you right in the middle there, right? Is this you in the middle?
Yeah,
right,
right there.
Look at this. Who are all these stars? Name some of you for me.
Janie
Good
Russell.
God. Gloria DeHaven, Dolores Gale Gray, Katherine Grayson, my God, Dorothy L'Amour,
Katherine Grayson,
Tony Martin, Gene Nelson,
Lorna Love next to me, and Arlene
Jane
Hall.
Russell. Oh my God, look at all
Gloria
these
DeHaven,
wonderful.
Dorothy L'Amour, yeah, and Van Johnson.
Katherine Grayson, still singing around? Is she still around?
Uh-huh. Oh, yes.
Is she doing? How is she doing nowadays?
Oh, fine. Yeah, she's doing great.
You see Jane Powell, all these MGM stars still? Jane
Once
lives
in a while.
Jane lives in New York, doesn't she?
Uh-huh. She and Dickie live in New York.
Uh-huh.
But sometimes she shows up at our PDS picnics, Professional Dancer Society.
Right.
Well, I was a dancer before I was a singer, so
you were
I'm
a dancer
a
before
member.
You were a singer?
Oh, yeah.
You studied dancing here in Hollywood?
Oh, yes. With the greatest. Louis Dupron and wait a minute. I'm trying to think.
That's okay.
All the greatest. Louis and
Willie
Colvin.
Right.
And, yeah, I was...
So you were a dancer before, you were a singer, actress?
Well, yeah, I was studying dancing. I didn't ever intend to sing.
Do you like the theater?
Oh,
in
yes.
Virginia?
Oh, I love the theater.
Because once you get into the films, then it's hard to get out of, you know, go to the theater. Unless you're really...
No, I'm used to theater.
You?
Oh, I've done all...
You've done a lot of summer theater, haven't you?
Not summer stock, but
you
theater.
Haven't?
No.
Theater. You've done a lot of theater.
Oh, yes.
I see. You do ship cruises? You go on ships, do you? All the stars are doing ship cruises.
I know.
Nowadays.
This is Margaret. She's on cruises.
Margaret O'Brien?
She's on cruises all the time. And she was talking to me, but you should go on one of those cruises. I said, oh, well, never been asked.
Uh-huh.
I've done, you know, been on a lot of ships, you know,
right.
On vacations.
So you do, they show your films and you talk? And
yeah, well, that's what happened. Charles Champlin, he went with us and he did... you know, emceed, like one day I would, you know, he'd interview me for the audience.
Right.
But they'd show my movie in the theater, then the next day they did the same thing with Ann Miller and with Virginia Mayo. So that's how this tour went. We didn't
You show clips
live.
From your films and stuff
yeah,
like that.
Right.
You know what I like to show? You brought me a clip and I want to show this clip.
This is what this I showed on board.
Is this what you showed on board? I want to show one of the clips from this, okay? May I show?
Sure.
Let's show the clip from Virginia O'Mail. Virginia O'Brien. Thank you.
That's all right.
Okay, darling.
The other day, some...
Smiling Flo! There's a face that was set for 7, but it didn't go off. Looks like Leon Henderson's freezing everything nowadays. Sing.
It was just a birthday party. Out to have some innocent fun. And when I wasn't looking, it slipped up on me. And now the damage is done. Stinking at the Club Savoy. Did I get thinking I was Myrna Loy? Did I get mingling with the hoi polloi? Boy, did I get stinking at the Club Savoy. Did I get clubby with the guy with Jack? He wound up giving me a piggyback. He had me swinging on the chandelier. Boy, did I get tighter than a mouse's ear. Edie was a lady. A lady is right. I thought I was a lady. At the Club Savoy. Did I get sailing with a ship ahoy? And going home I met a sweet convoy. Boy, did I get stinking at the Club Savoy. Ho, 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 ho. I really wasn't thinking when I started into drinking, and I wound up getting stinking at the Club Savoy. Ho, ho! You really would have died when I started getting fried, and I wound up getting pied at the Club Savoy. Started out with scotches, then switched to rye, then a little bitty bitty zombie. My, oh my, oh my. Today my head is floating in a fog. It really shouldn't happen to a dog. Today my life is not a thing of joy. Boy, did I get stinking. Get stinking. Did I really get stinking at the Club Savoy?
Uh-huh. Was that Panama Hattie?
That was.
That was great. Who's in that film?
Of course, you saw Red Skelton.
Red Skelton.
And the fellows around with Ben Blue and Rags Raglan.
Ben Blue.
Yeah.
God, was
they were the three sailors that were crazy. Uh-huh, in that movie. Uh-huh.
And who else?
And Ann Southern.
Uh-huh. Freak.
And Dan Daly. And, oh.
God, these stars you've been working with. It's Virginia Prime. I mean,
I did. This was a Broadway show, you know, Panama Hattie. Mr. Mayor bought.
Right.
So I did a couple of the songs that Ethel Merman did on Broadway. Fresh as a Daisy, that's another song that's in there. Walter Donaldson wrote this song.
What goes through Virginia O'Mine's mind when you are singing directly into the camera, looking straight ahead like stiff and all that? I mean, you're thinking of your lyrics, I understand, but isn't it difficult to work that way, Virginia's face, you know, blank face and all that?
That's why I do it. It's easy.
It's easy for you. It is? It's easy for you.
Yeah.
Ann Southern, tell me, what kind of lady was she?
I love working with Ann.
Really?
Uh-huh. She was fun to be around.
What made her so much fun to work with?
Well, she just, you know, herself and, you know, a lot of, some stars, I think, I can't recall which one, but they're very starish, you know what I mean?
Are there a lot of stars like that?
Yeah, yeah.
They are into themselves?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Red Skelton, one of the greatest comedian entertainers ever.
Funny.
Is he always funny that way?
Well, he wears you out, actually, on the set, because he's always doing something really weird. And the thing is, Red and his wife, Edna, at the time, were really good friends. Mm-hmm. And I'd be out at their home. They lived out in Reseda, and they were at my mom and dad, because I lived at home.
Right.
And I wasn't married yet. So, actually, once after they moved to Brentwood, Red and Edna asked me to come out for dinner, and I met Kirk, my first husband.
Uh-huh.
So Red and Edna introduced me to Kirk Allen.
Uh-huh. You've had some good memories in about MGM days, like Louis B. Mayer. Was he a real tough man, or was he?
People think he was. He was tough, because he was a businessman. He was running an empire.
Right.
You know, he knew what he was doing. But he was nigh, when I was doing Merton of the Movies with Red, which I didn't sing in, he gave me the lead.
Right.
And he'd come down on the set, you know, walk around with his arm around me, just talking and, you know, just down to earth, nice. I loved Mr. Mayer. And of course, he was a good friend of my dad's.
Your dad was the sheep?
Well, yeah.
Right, of course. Yeah. A book? How about a book? Are you writing a book?
I am. I've been making notes, Skippy, for years, and I came to a thing just recently, and I thought, well, I don't think anybody'd buy it. I don't have anything
Why not?
In it.
Oh, yes, you're one of the MGM's greats, darling.
You think it would?
Of course you are. You are one of the
Because I wasn't
MGM's.
Allowed to go out with anybody, and...
Look
you know,
at
I don't
you
have
here. Look, I want to show you something. This is put on the Ritz, and here you are with our. Look at these people you're with. Give me this picture. This is you, and this next one is Dolores Gray, and the next one is Arlene Dahl. Is that?
Yes.
And the other one is
Jane Russell.
Jane Russell. Now, there are four greats. You're legends. You know. How about Lana Turner? Good friends on the set.
Lana.
MGM.
Oh, I know.
Come on, tell me about Lana. I just adore her.
You know, we'd see each other at different functions and things. We weren't bosom buddies or anything like that, but I really loved
Lana. Who was Virginia O'Brien's bosom buddies on the set?
Eleanor Powell was my bosom buddy.
The tap dancer?
Yeah. Ellen
Parker. I loved her.
Yes.
And how about Judy Garland?
And Judy. Well, I didn't see her. You know, we weren't.
What made Eleanor Powell and Virginia O'Brien such bosom buddies? I mean, you go out.
Well, we did, you know, movies. We played, you know, parts together. You
right,
know,
right.
Like in Ship Ahoy.
Uh-huh.
You know, we were girlfriends.
I see.
You know, we didn't know
Ship
each
Ahoy
other.
Is the film. That was a great film, wasn't it?
It was fun.
Oh, God, she did some great dancing in it. Ann Miller? How about Ann Miller?
And Annie.
Annie?
Actually, I didn't know Ann that well. We didn't do movies together.
Right, but you were on the set.
Well, sure.
God, all
and we had more fun. I just love being with her on that, you know, on that cruise.
Uh-huh. This is great. This is Virginia O'Brien, Virginia Mayer and you?
Uh-huh.
Look at this.
That was in the
This
captain's.
Is on the cruise?
Yeah, that was on the cruise.
Uh-huh.
Captain gave us.
I want to show this. This is your husband and you?
Yes, that's on the staircase.
This
on
is
the
Harry.
Side of
Harry,
York.
This is Harry White.
Yes.
Oh, look at Harry White, Virginia O'Brien. How long have you been married to Harry White?
23 years.
23 years, having a good time. Harry's such an easy guy to get along with, isn't he?
He really is. And
what makes him so easy to get along with? He's so.
I think because he's an Aquarian or something. That's what they say.
You brought it. You got another clip. I got to show you from MGM. This is another clip I want to show. It's great. It's one of my favorites. Okay?
Okay.
Let's see another clip of Virginia O'Brien, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer.
The mayor of Panama's been using her voice until the air raid sirens get here.
I was a sunken souffle, a shirt still looking for starch. I was a ballroom after the ball. I was a fallen arch. I was a frozen asset, a burlesque without a tee. Then suddenly, from over the sea, came, well, just look at me, please. I'm fresh as a daisy, tough as a stake, mean as a miser, low as a snake, scared as a rabbit, small as a mite, gay. As a meadowlark, high as a kite, and wild.
As a tiger.
And drunk.
As a fool.
And sour.
As a lemon.
And stubborn.
As a mule.
And sweet.
As a cookie.
And pure.
As a dove.
I'm fresh as a daisy, hard as a rock, fit as a fiddle, proud as a cock, bright as a button, sly as a fox, shy as a violet, strong as an ox, light as a feather, blind as a bat, mad as a hatter, nervous as a cat, sharp as a razor, smooth as a glove, and that means mister. I'm in love.
I don't understand. How do you see Virginia O'Brien looking at yourself on film nowadays when you see yourself on film? I mean, your waist was so thin and you were so beautiful and you're still beautiful.
This is
but
BK,
tell me,
before kids.
No.
That was before kids.
Yeah, but tell me, when you see yourself, how do you feel?
I love the movies.
You still, it doesn't frighten you to see yourself or get scared now?
No.
You have some good memories about the studio.
Oh, yes. Oh, goodness, yes.
So you don't have no regrets, Virginia O'Brien, sitting there telling me that you've had a good time in life. You've had a good
time. I'm still doing it. That's what I wouldn't, of course.
Yes, you're performing. I
just love to.
You could be performing for the
Motion Picture Home, which I've been doing for 33 years,
uh-huh.
long before Mr. Mayer's Theater was built. And we're doing a show in the Lodge now. We don't do the dingling shows anymore because the... older people, they were 80 and 90, they were doing the show, so a lot of them aren't around anymore. But we're doing a birthday show on the 11th, and Fayard, it'll be, I'm doing Ethel Merman, I'm doing I Got Rhythm, which I've done before, and then Fayard's going to do Sammy Davis, and someone from New York, I don't know, his name is Gardner or something, he's doing Liberace, and I don't know who else.
Does
Paula
Virginia O'Brien believe in fate? Like, you know, if you weren't at that theater that day, and Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer wouldn't see you, do you believe in fate?
Life? Good question. I have really never thought about it, Skippy.
You haven't?
No.
You're not going to be doing a book. You say no one would.
Well, maybe you've spurred me on to really continue.
Because you keep your life busy. You keep happy. You're a mayor. You're married. You have children. Your children, matter of fact, are in the business. One is a drummer or something.
No, Terry. She used to be a drummer, but now she plays electric bass.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
She has a band.
Well, she had for years. Jenny Jones, who's on NBC now.
Right.
She was the drummer in an all-girl
Jenny
band.
Jenny Jones was in the drum with your daughter?
Yeah, they
really?
Had a group for years.
That's right. And then she became a comedian.
Yeah.
Is that the Jenny Jones?
The one that's on
A talk show lady.
Yeah,
I remember that. I remember it very
well. Uh-huh.
Your daughter's a wonderful, wonderful guitarist.
Oh, yeah.
Well, she sings, too.
She backs me up. When I'm at the Hollywood Vine Street or at the Motion Picture
You do
home.
Work at the Vine Street in Hollywood?
I've only been there five times.
Virginia, I didn't know that. I'm sitting here thinking, I didn't know that. How wonderful.
Yeah, the gardenia.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
You know, I don't go down there anymore, but because I make an entrance. I have to walk around the block to make my entrance in the gardenia.
So you do all your songs, all your songs from the films that you've done on your act right now?
Yeah. Well, the album that you saw before, you know, you didn't see it today, a tribute to the MGM musicals.
Uh-huh.
See, that's the...
That's okay, darling.
No, it isn't. I'm going to do it anyway.
Okay.
From the MGM, see?
Oh, the Virginia O'Brien Salute, the great MGM musicals.
And those are the songs that I do.
This is your album. I didn't know that. Oh, this is great. It's out now?
Yeah.
It's out now.
It's been out for about 8 years.
Uh-huh. I didn't
And when know. I was in London, I went into Tower Records, and they had, you know, they're selling it over there also.
Uh-huh. So Virginia O'Brien says you're having a good time in life.
Oh, yes.
And you've
had six wonderful grandchildren, which are...
How many years were you with MGM?
10.
10 years.
Uh-huh.
Seemed like a long time, doesn't it? With all those films you did. I mean, you did all
but
these...
Then they...
Frank Sinatra, tell me about Frank.
How about Frank?
Well, you worked Till Clouds Roll By. He was in it. Lena Horne.
I know that.
Tell me about Frank Sinatra.
Why?
Why? Because I like to know, because he loves you.
Yeah.
And Lena Horne adores
you.
He'd
had me over when he was having tests made for, you know, his face, because he had a little, from being a breech baby. And they had to test him a lot, you know, makeup-wise. So he'd ask me to come over, and then he asked me out one night.
A date?
Yes,
you have a date.
And then, of course, I was living at home with my mom and dad.
Right.
And she said, "No, you're supposed to meet him down at the hotel he was living on Vine Street, hotel.
You had to meet him?
He wanted me to meet him down, and he'd take me. My mother said, "No, why don't you get a hold of him and have him come out here for dinner?"
Right.
So.
Did he come out?
Are you kidding? No way, Jose.
Was that the last date with Virginia O'Brien with Frank Sinatra? Was it really?
That was it.
Who's some of the dates that you used to go out with in MGM? They used to set up your dates for you?
With Bob Sterling. They'd have him take me. I never went out with, you know.
Any of
them. And Bill Orr and let's see who else.
How did you meet your husband now? Harry White? He's a great guy. Great guy.
Through a mutual friend at the Irish.